I go by the name of ClassiQ, and I'm here to take you inside the Gargajiya video shoot. You know, as viewers, you guys don't know the struggle and bustle and sacrifices that go into shooting a video, especially as historic as this. So I'm here to share with you guys. Stay tuned. A lot of people have been asking, like, where'd you get the inspiration for this particular song? And I simply say, like, you know, I got it from the greats, the Mama Shata, Alhaji Musa Alankwero, Barmani Choke, Mariah Joss, Abuasha, you know, I could go on and on and on and on and on. And these are people that, you know, are the origin of real original Hausa music. So I just sat down one day and thought about it, like, the heritage must not die. We need to keep it going. Do you get what I'm saying? So this is like 50s, 60s, 70s sound, bringing it back to like the 2000s. And it's not been easy because I actually had to go back, study these people's music, like properly, to be able to come out with this sound, this particular music, this Gargajiya vibe. Do you understand what I'm saying? So it's a lot of work, but I'm glad I did, because the culture must live on, because we are Northerners and we need to export the culture to the world, and that's what it is. These are actually legends, and God bless them. Their soul rest in perfect peace, and their legacy must not die. That's why people like us are still alive, to make sure that continues. So Gargajiya the movie is not just a regular video, you know, it's something that depicts our rich cultural heritage, and that's why we went extra mile, or, you know, extra miles, like some people will say, to go to various locations, talking about Katsina, talking about Bauchi State, talking about Niger Republic, do you understand? And then talking about Zaria. Other states were coming, because the problem is the culture is so vast that you can just, you know, put everything in one documentary or one video or one movie. You understand? So it's a continuous process. I'm talking about Katsina, shout out to Katsina. You know, they allowed us use the palace since 1348. Like, they've not allowed anybody use that place. You understand? But then I think when preparedness comes with opportunity, things happen. You understand? And we got the privilege to shoot there, and it was such a pleasure. Like, I couldn't believe my eyes. Do you understand? They spoke to us about how many people, like people came to actually wanted to shoot there, but then they declined. All praise to the Almighty. They saw our vision, and they saw how determined we were. You get me? They saw the determination, and then they connected. You get what I'm saying? And then the other location was Bauchi State. Everything this video is intended, because Sir Abaga Tafabalia, the first Prime Minister of Nigeria, you know, is from my state. I'm from Bauchi State. You understand? He's one of my mentors. He's somebody I really look up to, because he's an upright man. It took a lot of planning. It took like 6 months to make this happen, and I'm happy. I'm happy I did, because this is something that's going to stand the test of time. You get what I'm saying? So everywhere we went to has and had a connection with the plan. Everything was intentional. You know what I'm saying? When you get to see the video, you understand where I'm coming from. Like, it was a lot of work. You know, I lost weight. Yeah, I lost weight because it wasn't easy. But then somebody said, like, what's worth doing is worth doing well. And I think that's a testimony of this video. So when it comes out, yeah, let me not talk too much. When it comes out, y'all going to understand, like what we went through to actually shoot this video, man. But I'm glad I was part of history, and I'm happy you guys are going to be part of this history with us together. Yeah, so just like all these legends that I've mentioned so far, and others that time wouldn't permit me to go into detail and mention any, you know, it's our responsibility, just like how they've laid down the legacy down for us, to continue in that lane. And that is bestowed on us as artists. And not just an artist, like other people who really believe in the culture and the rich culture, rich Nigerian culture, to continue. And it's our job to educate ourselves and then the generation to come, because it's so rich and so vast that job they work do aqua aiki was that, you know what I'm saying? So what am I trying to say? It's not just about music. Make music, enjoy yourself, but then educate the youth, educate the next generation. That way, just like how legends that we've mentioned are remembered, we also shall be remembered too. That's what's up. They say teamwork makes the dream work. So right now I want to take time to appreciate everybody that was involved in this suffering. Yeah, I won't call it suffering, it is success. You know what I'm saying? Because everybody put in all their efforts, and I'm not taking that for granted one bit. Watch out for the video. This is something you've never seen before, ladies and gentlemen. Historic, monumental, awesome, bombastic. Fact. See you on the other side. Boom.